Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 4.1, Problem 9. This is Section 4.1, Problem 9. It says pivot the highlighted element, and we have a tableau with the following columns. There's an X1 column, X2, X3, S1, S2, Z, and of course RHS for right-hand side. And this tableau has three rows. The top row is 1, 2, 4, 1, 0, 0 again, and then 56. Next, the second row is 2, 2 again, 1, 0, 1, 0, 40. And then the bottom row, the last row, is negative 1, negative 3, negative 2, 0, 0 again, 1, and then 0. And it says pivot the highlighted element, and the element that was highlighted in the problem is in the X2 column, there's a 2 in the middle row, and that's highlighted. I did it in a different color on the whiteboard so it would stand out. So to pivot that highlighted element means to turn it into a 1, and then to zero out the rest of the column that it's in. It's like solving one column of a matrix. So we need to make the 1 first. So to make a 1, we multiply the whole row that the pivot point is in by 1 over whatever the pivot is now. You don't have to add two rows together. That's for making a 0. So when I turn that into a 1, the top row of the original matrix is not going to change. It can stay the way it is, which is 1, 2, 4, 1, 0, 0, 56. So that was the top row originally, and it's the top row in the next matrix down. It can stay the way it is. Now, for the second row, what I'm going to write off to the side is row 2 equals 1 over 2 times row 2, or 1 half times row 2, if you like. And it's because it's 1 over the value that I need to turn into a 1 is currently a 2. So 1 over that number, 1 over 2. And again, notice, same sign to make a 1. They're both positive. It's opposite sign when we make zeros. So I'm going to multiply 1 over 2 times every value in the second row. And as I go through, I'm going to do 1 over 2 times 2. 2 over 2, which reduces to 1. Then the same thing in the next position, 1 over 2 times 2, which again is 2 over 2, which reduces to 1. The next position, I'm going to do 1 over 2 times 1, which is 1 over 2, which doesn't reduce. So I'll put it in 1 half. You can write it as a 0.5 if you like. I don't mind the fractions. Next, 1 over 2 times 0 is 0. Next, 1 over 2 times 1 is 1 over 2, or a half. Again, I'll leave it as a half. I'll leave the fraction. Next, I have 1 over 2 times 0, which is 0. And finally, 1 over 2 times 40, which is 40 over 2, which will reduce to 20. And now, in terms of making the 1, I don't involve any other rows. So the bottom row from the matrix I'm working on now, my second matrix of the problem, is going to stay the same. It's going to stay negative 1, negative 3, negative 2, 0, 0 again, 1, and 0. And then I'll do the next matrix down in a different color, again, just to make each one stand out. So far I've made the 1. Now I need to make the rest of that X2 column into zeros. So there's a 2 in the top position of the X2 column that needs to become a 0. It's a positive 2 now. So next to the top row of the matrix I'm going to make now, I'm going to put row 1 equals some stuff plus the old row 1. And I'm working in row 1 because that's the row where I need to make the 0. And I'm ending in row 1 because my equation that I write off to the side has to begin and end with the same thing. So I start with row 1, I must end with row 1. Now what I call stuff is the row at the pivot point, so row 2, times the same number but opposite sign is what has to become a 0. What has to become a 0 is a positive 2, so it has to be times a negative 2 in my equation. So the equation I'm going to use to make a new top row is row 1 equals negative 2 times row 2 plus the old row 1. And that'll make my 0 where it has to go, but it's going to change every value in the top row. I can't just do that for the one position in the column I'm pivoting. I have to do it for the whole top row. So as I do it, negative 2 times row 1 is negative 2 times 1, which is minus 2, plus row 1, so plus 1. Minus 2 plus positive 1 is negative 1. Next, in the X2 column, I'm going to do negative 2 times row 2 is negative 2 times 1, which is negative 2, plus row 1, so negative 2 plus positive 2, which is 0. That's what I wanted to get. Next, I'm going to do negative 2 times rho 2 is negative 2 times a half, which is minus 1 plus rho 1. So minus 1 plus 4 is positive 3. Then in the next column, I have negative 2 times rho 2 is negative 2 times 0, which is 0, plus rho 1. So I have 0 plus 1, which is 1. The next column over, negative 2 times rho 2 is negative 2 times a half. That's minus 1. Plus rho 1, so plus 0. Minus 1 plus 0 is minus 1. The next column, I'm going to do negative 2 times rho 2 is negative 2 times 0. So that's 0. Plus rho 1, so I'll do 0 plus 0. That's 0. And finally, in the last column, negative 2 times rho 2 is negative 2 times 20. That's negative 40. Plus rho 1 would be negative 40 plus 56. Positive 16. Now, the next row in my matrix, or the tableau, has the 1 in it that I'm using as a pivot, so I don't want to change anything. I'm just going to leave that second row exactly the way it is. It's going to stay 1, 1 again, 1 half, 0, 1 half, 0, and 20. Now, the last thing I have to do is in the x2 column, there's a negative 3 in the bottom position. That negative 3 must be turned into a 0. So, to make it a 0, I'm working in row 3. So next to row 3, I'm going to write a little equation. It's going to be row 3 equals some stuff plus the old row 3. My equation starts with row 3 because that's the row I'm making the 0 in. It ends with row 3 because it should begin and end with the same row. Now, in the middle of my equation, what I just called stuff, is going to be the row with the pivot position, which is row 2, times the same number opposite sign as what's becoming a 1, becoming a 0, sorry. What's becoming a 0 is a negative 3, so same number opposite sign is a positive 3. So the equation I'm going to use to make my new row 3 is row 3 equals positive 3 times row 2 plus the old row 3. And again, I'm going to apply that equation to every position in row 3, not just the one I need to change into a 0. So the first position, 3 times row 2 is 3 times 1, that's positive 3, plus row 3. So I'm going to have positive 3 plus negative 1 is a positive 2. The next position, 3 times row 2 is 3 times 1, that gives me a positive 3, plus row 3. So I have positive 3 plus negative 3, which is a 0. The next position, I have 3 times row 2 is 3 times a half, so that's 1 and a half, positive 1 and a half, plus row 3. So I have positive 1 and a half plus negative 2, so that's minus a half, positive 1 and a half, and negative 2 is negative 1 and a half. The next position, I have 3 times row 2 is 3 times 0, plus row 3 is plus 0, so 0 plus 0 is 0. And then next, 3 times row 2 is 3 times a half. So again, 3 times a half is 1 and a half. Plus row 3. So 1 and a half plus 0. 1 and a half plus 0 is 1 and a half. Or 3 halves, or 1.5, however you want to write it, is fine. The next column over, I have 3 times row 2 is 3 times 0, which is 0. Plus row 3. So I have 0 plus 1. 0 plus 1 is 1. And finally, the last column, 3 times row 2 is 3 times 20, which is 60. And then plus row 3, I'm going to have 60 plus 0. So 60 plus 0 is 60. And I have completed the pivot.